everybody, this is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBites.com. Today we're going to learn about America's 8th president, Martin Van Buren. Martin Van Buren was born in Kinderhook, New York in 1782. Martin's father was a farmer and owned an inn where many politicians came to stay. When he was 13 years old, Martin quit school and began working at a law office. Around this time, many people began to notice that he was a good public speaker. At just 18 years old, he helped Thomas Jefferson get elected as America's 3rd president. This made Martin more well known throughout the country. In 1807, Martin married Hannah Hose. Sadly, she died before her husband became president, and Martin had to raise their 4 sons by himself. In 1812, 5 years after he married Hannah, Mr. Van Buren became a U.S. Senator from New York. He founded a political group called the Albany Regency and attended New York's 2nd Constitutional Convention. In 1828, Mr. Van Buren was elected as the governor of New York. While he was governor, he helped to get Andrew Jackson elected as America's 7th president. While Andrew Jackson was president, Mr. Van Buren worked as his Secretary of State. This is a very important job that involves a lot of decision-making regarding America's relationships with other countries. When President Jackson ran for a 2nd term, he chose Mr. Van Buren to be his vice presidential candidate. Together they won, and Mr. Van Buren became the next vice president of America. In 1836, after Andrew Jackson's time as president ended, Mr. Van Buren ran for president as a Democrat and won. One of the reasons Mr. Van Buren won was because he told the American people that he would make some of the same decisions that President Andrew Jackson made. This pleased many Americans. 1 year later, a depression called the Panic of 1837 began. Many businesses and banks failed, which made them lose all of their money. President Van Buren tried to help by making a stronger banking system for America. However, President Van Buren continued living lavishly, buying many things for himself. This made many Americans very angry, because he was getting richer while they were getting poorer. One time, while Mr. Van Buren was president, America and Canada almost fought in a war because they could not decide on borders between their countries. President Van Buren helped to prevent a war by negotiating a peace deal with Canada that eventually led to the Webster-Ashburton Treaty in 1842. Just like Andrew Jackson, President Van Buren also forced Native Americans to move out west. In 1838, the Cherokee Indians were forced to take a long and difficult journey to what is now the state of Oklahoma. As a result, many of them suffered and died on their journey. This is why it is known as the Trail of Tears. Because of the problems that occurred while Mr. Van Buren was president, he did not get reelected in 1841. After his presidency ended, Martin Van Buren went home to Kinderhook, New York, where he died on July 24, 1862, during the Civil War, also known as the War Between the States. An interesting fun fact is that Mr. Van Buren's supporters would call him OK, which stood for Old Kinderhook. Kinderhook, New York, was the place where Martin Van Buren was born. During his presidency, he started signing papers with the initials OK, and this is how the popular phrase, OK, began. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBites.com, and until next time, go learn your history.